Yes, I wanted to make a video about how to make a printed circuit board. I've made the artwork available online for a lot of my projects, but I think for a lot of you, making the printed circuit board is a bit of a challenge. So this hopefully will clarify things. This is an Arduino shield board I've made, and actually I've made several different variations of this with just changing the little parts I need or parts of the designs I need. This one has an X10 transmitter on board, serial interfaced on the Arduino. We'll also have an LCD display and temperature sensors and some solid-state relays. Now, this video is not about the design work. It's just really about making the board. And so you have to figure out how to design these things. I use Lab Center's CAD program. And what you get there is this artwork. Okay, and artwork can be looked at as many different layers there. Some of different information, top layer, and you probably can get 15 layers if you want here too. But once you get the artwork done, then you're just going to need to select the layers you want to print. And usually for me, it's going to be top layer, bottom layer. And then I'll print just that information. I use a laser printer. And basically, just run through on regular stock paper, print the layers I want. And then what I'm going to do, I'm going to actually use this blue press and peel. And I like this stuff because you can just cut a small square of it, put it right on top of what you printed on your paper, and put a small piece of tape on the top just to hold it in place. And then once you get that, then you run the whole thing back through your printer again, straight through. Don't go around the corner like I did. I just found out my printer would not do a straight through. And it kind of smeared the toner a little bit. But once you get it printed up, go ahead and trim it with scissors. In fact, you really don't want to leave any excess of this plastic. I think the more excess plastic, the more areas to catch and more areas to expand. And I found out just cutting what you want is the best to have here too. And be kind of careful when you're cutting it. Try to keep your fingers off in areas that are critical, because the oil can actually, from your fingers, can interfere with the transfer process. So yeah, get that cut out here. And then you're also going to need to get a nice clean printed circuit board of good quality. And I mean Scotch-Brite clean with 91% or 91 proof alcohol, whatever it is, rubbing alcohol. Really clean the thing up here too. Now this is a trick I've learned. Instead of just putting the cold plastic on top of cold printed circuit board and having them both expand up and kind of, if it's expanding while you're heating it, it's going to give you kind of a smeary print. You want to kind of heat up both areas. Get them all heated up so they're all expanded as big as they're going to be. And then once you get it, then you can actually quickly, because it's going to be hot, put it in the board and just kind of keep on pressing and turning. Don't try to slide, because I think shear forces here will make this thing move a little bit. So we want to kind of be fragile. Be careful. It's kind of fragile in this state here too. But just keep on pressing and turning and pressing and turning. Don't use the edge. Try to keep it nice and flat. And about 2 or 3 minutes later, you're going to find it's going to be stuck down really well. And you should still see that it's actually all really appeared. Now what I usually do, I take that right to the water faucet. Quickly cool it down. And you use like a little paring knife to get an edge up. And the water just peels it right off. Okay, and what you have left, you can see how it's transferred to. Any place there's toner, it will transfer to the board. Where there's no toner, no transfer. But now, again, this is a pretty messy board. I have to say, I've made a lot cleaner ones here too, but get a Sharpie pen. If you got any errors in the masking of the toner, just repair it with a Sharpie pen, and also use like an X-Acto knife to clean up any grooves or if a line or a trace got too close to another one, or a pad got too out of shape, just clean them up right now. And basically, once you get the toner out of the way, and then I take it to a bandsaw, cut away any excess I have of the copper. I don't want to waste my etching solution, etching copper. I'm just going to cut away later. So once you get it all clean, and at this state here, then I'll take it to a ferric chloride, bubble it for 45 minutes or so, and it will eat away any of the copper. And what you're left with is basically the copper still there underneath the toner, but basically it's eaten away everything it can get hold of. So that's it. Sorry, this is a little out of focus here too, but I think you can get the gist of that then too. Now, once you get this toner, I've seen people make recommendations of just Use a Scotch-Brite or steel wool to get the toner off. But what I found here is it works so slick. Is just get some lacquer thinner, do this outside with good gloves on. I usually get a couple of paper towels here of lacquer thinner on there, and lacquer thinner really dissolves the toner quickly. And usually a couple of them, because I'll get most of the toner off on the first one, then I'll switch over to a good clean paper towel, and it will actually clean the rest of it up here too. So that makes really fast work of it here too. But again, this is something to do outside. Lacquer thinner's nasty stuff inside the house, and flammable and all those terrible things. But anyway, like I said, even though it's not the cleanest board I've ever made, this will still be a very functional board. So, and I'll also take a little eraser sometimes, just a paper pencil eraser, and kind of buff it up. The cleaner it is, the better it's going to solder. Then I take it to a drill press, and I really like these high-speed drill bits. In fact, mine move a little bit quicker than this video is showing. The carbide ones are really nice, however, they're also fragile. And you can see when you're drilling through here that it will try to lift the printed circuit board up, because that's the nature of the drill bit. It kind of brings it up here too. And if you're not paying attention, what's going to happen, it's going to lift it up too much and it's going to snap the drill bit. Believe me, I've been there, done that type of thing. So on the rows, be kind of really careful where you have pins going in, because sometimes the machine pins you put are not very forgivable. And sometimes you got to take the whole thing off and blow the dust out of the way so you can actually see what you're drilling. So yeah, sometimes I'll jump around just because the areas are clean. And I'm not going to show the whole board here. And this is probably the most boring part of the whole process. But really, it's not too bad once you get into a routine there too. But take your time on these. There is a little indentation there too that helps it center the drill bit. And again, just hold it up to a light. You can see a couple ones I've missed here. But that'll give you an idea how to, where you need to drill. Sometimes I'll even clean the back up. I have a sub D 9 going in here. Sometimes the pins are a little bit bigger, and I'll clean the back up. And actually, I drilled bigger holes where the little spring load clips of the sub D 9 fit. And I'll solder all this stuff in. Basically, all the pins, all the connectors to the Arduino are just all soldered in. Any resistors I need, these are pull down resistors for the switches I'm going to use here too. But anyway, this is a wonderful skill set to have. It's really just a little bit of techniques you need here too. But anyway, hope this helps out here a little bit, and really, thanks for watching.